Well, with all the volatility in the stock markets and the price of oil remaining low, nice little rebound over the past couple of days, but still just barely around $30 a barrel. Everyone's trying to figure out what it means for house prices going forward. REMAX's Sam Correa is here to shed a little bit of light on what we can expect in the housing market for the coming year. And Sam, we have talked a lot about this particular recession.
Yes.
And how it feels different maybe than others. You've got some great points to compare some of the recessions that we've seen over the years.
Exactly.
And you're going to give us a sense of just what the differences are. We're going to start with looking at the 80s. Of course, many born and raised Albertans will remember the 80s recession well. What are some of the key differences?
Well, so in my travels, a lot of people compare this to the 80s recession, and I think it's worthy to note that we're completely different from the 80s. A couple main factors, of course, the big one is the double-digit interest rates we had through the 80s. Right. Of course, they peaked in the high 22%, 24% interest rate. The big ones, of course, is we had double-digit unemployment rate. And that was, of course, today we only have about 7%, and that relatively is completely off. And the last one is the migration rate. People in the 80s, from 81 to 85, were leaving Calgary in record numbers. So the migration rate was decreasing substantially at that time.
And so as far as you're concerned, when you're comparing this recession to the 80s, you're saying this is much more mild. The conditions are much more favorable than they were in the 80s when this happened then.
Correct. I mean, the interest rate alone near zero is a big one. Right. And of course, we still had a migration rate of 12,000 increase from last year. So people aren't moving out as much as they were in the 80s.
Yeah, let's talk about the latest recession. Okay. I guess I don't know when it technically started, probably 2007. Okay. They call it the Great Recession. What are some of the similarities and differences there?
Well, I think the big one is price. Certainly from the 80s to the Great Recession, we saw inventory and price kind of coming up for those two times in our market.
Right. We're looking at it here. The point you make here is that the crisis was widespread, way beyond the energy sector.
Yes.
Whereas right now it's very specific to oil, it seems.
If for sure, and I think Calgary held did a little bit better through the Great Recession because, of course, the tech stocks that were dropping at that time didn't affect local Calgarians as much.
Right.
We're really more affected through the oil, and as a result, we're seeing a change through people's positions right now.
Okay. CREB releasing some numbers to give us a sense of what we can expect in 2016. Let's have a look at some of the forecasts. First, a reduction in the number of sales is expected.
Yeah. So Anne-Marie Laurier is our chief economist at CREB, and she's very consistent. I enjoy listening to her every year. We just had our forecast last week, and her prediction for 2015 was very accurate. 2016, she's predicting that our actual amount we're going to fall for activity is about 2.2%, okay, which means an average price drop of about 3.44%, and that's kind of the prediction leading into 2016.
Okay, so a drop in price, but certainly less significant than it conceivably could have been. Here it is here, the price forecast. So
3.44% is the prediction and drop in price. And I think how those numbers lay out is we came out of such a banner year of 2014. It took a while for those numbers to kind of settle into 2015, but now that's starting to settle. We're certainly going to see a bit of a drop.
Anecdotally, I hope you don't mind me asking, how are things going for you? I mean, if you compare the years and what you're sort of seeing out there amongst yourself and your colleagues, how are things sort of shaping up in comparison?
Well, what's really interesting, the first month of 2015, a lot of people were certainly on the fence and didn't jump into the market.
Right.
And I think that's definitely of different vibe today than it was a year ago. And just in the last 30 days, I personally transacted 5 homes over $1 million, and quite excited to say that 2 of those homes were over $3 million, representing the buyers, and that hadn't happened since April of 2015.
Yeah, so those 2.5 plus, I think that was the benchmark. We had a conversation of it last year. Nothing was moving over 2.5.
No, I think April of 2015 was really the last sale over $3 million, but just in the last 30 days, 2 buyers I've been working with realized the value, obviously jumping into the market, and so quite excited to report
that. So many people may be sensing the bottom then.
They're jumping in now before they lose their opportunity. So pretty exciting stuff happening just recently.
Great insight as always. It's REMAX's Sam Correa. And for more information, head to samcorea.ca.